Hello and welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I'm the RPG chick. Let's stare into the darkness.
Aside from the light coming through the hole, you can hardly see a thing down here. But I think I need more than just a torch or something like that. It sounds like I'm in a fairly large cavern.
Talk to the voices some more. They say they're gods, by the way. This is Wilbur, by the way. Oh, we can climb back up the rope or just talk to the voices. Can't even walk farther than this. And we walk back to talk to them.
Hello? Are you still there?
Because it's safe here.
Where else would we be?
Can't you give me a little help here?
You got a map?
There's a little rat sitting up there who misses his uncle.
Emotion overcame the dwarf, and tears of anger and exhaustion welled up in his eyes.
He's not a dwarf.
That's not true. And I'm not a dwarf.
Tell him.
You must understand, the protagonist must come up against problems. No conflicts, no story.
He's got plenty of problems.
Put as many obstacles in his way as you like, but can you still help me?
Perhaps a joke would calm the situation down.
Oh, please, no.
No.
I need to find a way to light this place up. It doesn't have to be a particularly bright light, but I'll have to be able to see into every nook and cranny if I want to find Remy.
A riddle that must be solved. And the solution leads to more riddles, and then...
As long as we get light, and we can start seeing something for a change.
Oh, you don't like that you don't have light either.
I just can't grope around in the dark. Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of caves?
Thought the dwarf, who didn't want to be one, whilst dead eyes were looking at him from the darkness.
Didn't want to be a dwarf.
Dead eyes?
He thought, and instinctively took a step backwards.
I didn't think it. I said it.
I noticed that too. Who does he keep talking to? Isn't he on his own?
Talking to you, nincompoops.
I need to find a way to... I just can't...
Thought the dwarf.
Dead.
He thought.
Okay, we're done cycling through all this. There's nothing we can do here except for go back up. What do we got with us? Maybe we can reflect this light? No? Nope. Let's go back up. We need a light, or something to make a light with. We didn't get very far, I'm afraid.
Up's even worse than down.
Wilbur, have you found Uncle Remy?
Nope.
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
I need a light, Timmy.
Timmy?
Yeah?
It's pretty dark down there. I need light.
You can hardly see your hand in front of your face down there. I need a light.
We could build a torch.
Build one?
Not only is it pretty dark down there, but pretty scary as well. A flickering torch that casts shadows? No thanks. I need something different. Something that illuminates the whole place. I've got to get back.
You can do it.
I'll find Remy. Timmy's been through enough already.
Okay. Maybe Ethel will have something.
Hi, Ethel.
Habit of creeping up on me.
Yep, that's us. I've been into the dark hole. It's dark.
I followed Remy down into the dark hole.
Ooh, what's it like?
Dark.
Dark.
Then you need to sort out some light. Chop chop.
Well, get it for me then.
Where are we going, Ethel?
If you need stew, you know where to find me.
All I need is something I can light it with her fire here.
She gets stuck. The pipe eventually gets to the magic school staff room, where the transformed archmage is being held captive. Unfortunately, I'm about 10 times too big to fit through the pipe.
Yep, there's small and then there's small. Well, we certainly don't have a lot of items to mess with. Let's get back up here. Maybe Ivo can help.
The basket will let Ivo and I exchange stuff. Very handy if one of us gets stuck at some point.
Well, we're stuck as far as stuck in the game.
Ivo?
What?
I need light. Can you help me with that?
For my search for Remy, I need something I can use to light an entire cave.
I'll keep my eyes peeled.
That'll Thanks. Hurt.
I have to get going. Don't get caught.
Good luck. Keep your ears stiff.
She always says that.
Ivo?
Yes.
Nothing. I just wanted to know if you were there.
Right. I'm here.
Ivo's there. Everything's fine.
Is that how you define fine? What am I supposed to be doing? I can't...
I'll find Remy.
What if he uses a paper hat? But to interact with... in what way? Well, I can't even move it around. All I can do is take it on and... I mean, put it on and take it off. Take it on and put it off, yeah. Sheesh. Nope, there's nothing I can do here.
They already have enough of the stuff. The rubbish stays here.
Well, I don't know what to do with anything.
The basket will let I bury it.
She's got to put a light in there, man. I don't know what to do. I have literally nothing to interact with in here. All I got is this mirror. Is there something in the basket now? No.
The basket will be very...
There's nothing to look at. I gotta be missing something. Oh wait, I can change to Ivo. Duh. Oh.
I don't know what I'd talk to Will, and quite honestly, I'd rather only stick my head down there when absolutely necessary.
So here's the lovebirds here.
I get the impression they would go through thick and thin together. They simply belong together. I'm really envious of that.
Oh, I. Well, Nate's a scoundrel.
Hi, you two.
Oh, hello.
Welcome to the town. My name is Ivo.
I've not had the pleasure of making your acquaintance yet. My name's Ivo. Welcome to Seastone.
My name is Gulliver. This is my enchanting lotus blossom, Esther.
Enchanting.
Our son down there with the ogre is called Nate.
Lotus blossom.
Nate?
Nate, yes. Named after a true hero and good friend. It was down to him that Esther and I got together back then in the wildlands.
And, you haven't bumped into Nate recently, have you?
About Nate? You haven't
haven't seen him recently, have you?
Unfortunately not. We would have loved to have had him at our wedding, but he suddenly disappeared.
I'm sure he's out there in the big wide world, helping other lovers find the happiness they deserve.
Is that what he does?
But he left his love behind in the process.
Do you know him?
That deceitful hypocrite who disappeared in the middle of the night with no explanation and leaving me standing there like an idiot of a pirate? No, I don't know him. Not anymore.
He's better friend material than boyfriend or husband material. So what are you going to do next? Where are you going to go?
It's not safe for you here in Seastone. Not for anyone.
I know, but where else can we go? Zombies and the undead aren't really welcome anywhere.
A graveyard?
People think that we eat their brains. But to be honest, they really don't taste of anything.
Ew. Or perhaps you'd be better off in the wildlands. There are loads of people like you there.
People like you.
Why do we have to go? Just because other people have a problem with us? That's not fair.
Well, yeah, but life's not fair. Maybe you can take over the slate production when this is all over.
Wilbur talked about the machine that you built together. Maybe you can bring it up here and build slates for yourself when everything's returned to normal.
I don't think so. Only Bill knows where to get the intelligent stone. And he'd claim I've stolen his idea. He can afford ghouls. Worse, lawyers. Anyway, where am I going to get the gold? Who would even lend me a copper piece?
Don't give up, Sunshine. Small setbacks are a part of death.
Esther's right. Those who fight may lose, but those who don't fight have lost already.
That's true.
Says the young, pretty and rich elf princess.
I've got to go now. Bye, you two.
Bye.
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 I'll let them have some time on their own. They've got to make a decision about where they're going to spend their life together. Not an easy decision. Hi, you two.
Oh, hello.
I thought we were going to leave them alone. Now you're saying hi to them.
I'll let them have some... They've got... Hi.
Oh, hello.
Alright, let's go down here. Oh, here's Nate.
This is Nate. His name isn't his fault. I'll try to be nice to him. Hello, N8. Are you interested in these toys, then?
N8, she calls them.
He says... Finally, I know where all the rubbish comes from.
You can understand him.
It's quite obvious what he thinks of this junk. I think he says
what's he doing?
Could also build something useful out of all this. He's an inventor.
Yep, like you can talk to Cheap Cheap. That's it? I thought he was about to do something. Anything new to say about the fire? Well, we can use this.
Don't feel the heat. Otherwise, elf.
If we find something to light the fire. Well, it just puts it on. It's silly. The hat's enough already.
Hello, Zloff. Blout.
Can I have your club?
Ah, Princess Ivo.
I want your ogre club. Would your mage knowledge extend to knowing how to light up a big dark cave?
A friend of mine who's active in the non-existent resistance has to somehow illuminate a big cave.
Sorry, guys.
I'm no longer a mage and have nothing to do with the resistance. And... Because I'm no longer a mage, I don't need my magical equipment anymore.
Nah.
Like, for example, this clicker, which can capture starlight.
Oh, it's a lighter? Thank you.
Good job that you aren't a mage anymore. Now I can give this thing to my friend, who's not on a wanted list and who's also not in the resistance, which also doesn't even exist.
Why talk so strange? Something not right here.
He got
You're
that right.
You're much too suspicious, dear Blout.
Thanks for the chat.
You were like a beacon of light in the darkness.
Yeah, we've heard it all before.
I don't know what there is to talk about at the moment. I'm an elf and don't otherwise.
Now, do we need to capture? Is this an actual... Do we need the fire, or is the can we make fire with this?
Sloth called this thing a clicker. Apparently one can use it to capture starlight. I know some fluorescing plants that collect sunlight during the day and then give it out at night. Perhaps it's something like that.
I can't even use it on that. Seems kind of obvious, right? Fire, yeah, but... Okay. So we gotta capture the starlight, which is up there. Anything new to say about the posters?
If I do my job right.
Nope.
When the cat's away, the mice will play. Let's go in.
Oh, we can go in now? Yeah, look around in here first. Oh!
What the... You could have hit me.
Yeah, whatever. No one's allowed to enter the school as long as the council leader's away.
I'm here on official business for the council leader.
Council leader Van Buren has asked me to get something from her office for her.
She didn't tell me. She only told me to knock the head off anyone who tries to get in here while she's away.
Well, presumably she forgot to mention it. She'll be very angry if I don't bring her what she requested.
Angry with you, not with me.
Oh, but you're such a good guard. Completely on the ball.
Oh, somebody's really on the ball here. I'm really decisive. Well done.
Yeah, no problem for a professional like me.
Oh, I'll mention that in my report.
What report?
Oh, I'm not really permitted to tell you, but let's just say a positive evaluation should give your career a boost.
But I'm exactly where I want to be.
Really?
Sure, otherwise I wouldn't be here.
You really enjoy your job, don't you?
Must have a ball every day harassing people.
A smart guy like me can really make good in this world.
But you're destined for greater things. Go out there and prove it.
I could, but I don't want to. Let everyone else bumble around if they want to. They always come crawling back asking for help at some point. And I just say, deal with your own shit, you bumblers.
Ooh, language. Wow.
Oh, what a delightful conversation.
Well, it's no surprise you liked it. Conversations with the one and only Grumda Klimpus are always a laugh.
Oh, so he's got a name.
It was rather disappointing for me. But you did your best.
Unless he's talking about who he was talking to.
His general appearance is not exactly pleasant. And his most defining feature is his melodious stink.
Think you're something special because you know all these long words, eh? Pathetic.
What, stink?
He's not particularly quick, physically nor mentally.
Haha, it's all. Learn English.
He's not particularly quick.
Well, let's just walk right past him.
I've got to get into the staff room, so that's where I'm going.
Of course you are. And I'm going to give you a taste of my axe.
You wouldn't hit me.
Despite the fat belly and skinny legs.
Will you please let me into the staff room?
Listening's an art. N-O. No.
Will you please... He's not particular.
Alright, that's it for that. Unless something in our bag of tricks.
He's not particularly. Will you please.
Listen.
Didn't work? Okay. You've convinced me. We'll capture the starlight.
I can't risk starting a fight with the troll. Yeah, I could get past him, but he might follow me and wake up half the town in the process. Annoyingly, I can't trick him either. He's just too stupid for that.
Too stupid to trick. Wow.
From up there, our problems must appear so small and insignificant. All this...
Yeah, I've seen this. Alright, let's use the clicker thingy.
Right then. Capture starlight. That is beautiful.
Wow.
If I'm not very much mistaken, there are a good few dozen stars, or at least a bit of their light in this thing.
I'd say some of the light, not actual stars. I wonder.
No entry!
He's not particular.
Nope. Alright. Go help Wilbur. Poor guys are homeless.
Yes?
A troll is guarding the school. I can't get into the staff room.
There's a fully grown troll with an axe in the entrance hall of the school, and he won't let me into the staff room. Is there another way into the school?
If we had some fireplace travel powder, you could get into the staff room through the fireplace.
Fireplace? I'm sure there isn't a fireplace in there. Presumably it's now a doll's house or something.
Maybe the fireplace in the library is still okay.
Worth a try. Just missing the powder now.
It's on the headmaster's desk.
Which brings us back to the start of our problem.
You can't get in.
Yep. That's about the size of it.
Brace yourself. I've captured some starlight for you.
I've captured a bit of starlight for you. That should make your light problems a thing of the past.
Really? Wow.
Yeah.
I'm going to send the clicker down in the basket. You must wait until you're in the dark cave before you set the starlight free.
Got it.
Okay.
That's all for now.
See you later.
I don't know what I'd talk to Wilbur about right now. And quite honestly, I...
Okay.
According to Ivor, this little thing should be full of starlight. Man, would I like to see that.
Okay. Well, I guess we're gonna see that.
I'll find Remy. I need to find a way to light this place up. Doesn't have to be a particularly bright light.
A little as long.
Magic clicker. Release the starlight.
Wow!
Cool.
Oh, that's bright.
That's right.
I can see.
By God, you got old.
Statues.
You're only statues.
We are gods trapped in statues. That, by the way, is a very exciting story.
I'm sure it
can
is.
Can someone help me up? Thank you.
Hey, all this light reminds me of a joke.
No.
Two trolls look up into the night sky.
Oh, God.
One asks the other, what do you think? Is there life on the moon? And the other replies,
light on.
Well, of course. There's a light on, isn't there?
Hey,
lie him face down in the sand.
Oh, I second that. We got all kinds of things to look at and interact with now. Let's look at the alcove.
Small alcove with some truly gruesome ornamentation. Whoever designed this thing must have been in an alarming state of mind. A small alcove, whoever...
Let's talk to this one. Is this the one who jokes?
So you're gods in statues. Did someone imprison you?
And so it came to pass that the young hero encountered the epic story, which...
The statues depict us. They are our last refuge.
I always thought gods lived somewhere up in the sky in really stylish cloud palaces.
I have lived in many temples, all of which were dedicated to me. The faithful met in them, discussing and answering the most difficult of questions. And they all paid homage to me, the god of riddles.
And then you were forgotten and ate sand for a few centuries.
That one calls himself Jerry, the god of bad jokes.
No kidding.
The god of humor.
That is Avini, goddess of the arts. And I am...
Hypnis, the chatterbox.
The god of good stories.
That was the god of narration.
One picture speaks more than 1,000 words.
Let's talk to the god of humor.
Yoo-hoo.
Yoo-hoo.
Oh, young friend, would you like to hear a joke?
Not especially. The god of humor. Sounds like a great job.
The god of humor. Wow. Sounds like you'd have a lot to laugh about.
Oh, of course. It'd be a sorry state of affairs if I didn't.
It is really bad if one constantly has to hear the same joke told time and time and time again.
Oh, you just haven't got a sense of humor. Listen, one politician says to the other, I don't know why no one likes us. We don't do anything.
He only knows like 3 jokes.
Or do you know the one?
Yes,
we know it.
Party poopers.
For a god of humor, you only know 3 jokes. And there's more to joke. I mean, there's more to humor than stupid jokes. I still don't get why humans live in statues down here. I mean, where gods live in statues down here.
I still don't understand why you're here and not somewhere beautiful instead. I mean, you're gods. Can't you do whatever you want?
Not anymore.
Of course we can. Well, theoretically.
In reality, though, no one has believed in us for a long while. Do you know how gods are created, young man?
To the belief of others.
I thought all of the gods had always been there.
Nah.
We get our power by people believing in us. It can be a great power. A power that can move mountains and flare up conflict.
But if no one believes in you anymore, nothing remains.
Our temples were destroyed centuries ago or rededicated to other more bloodthirsty gods.
Bloodthirsty?
These 4 statues are all that remain. If they disappear, we, like our religion, will cease to exist.
I noticed that appallingly decorated alcove above it. Above what? What's that all about, then?
What's up with this creepily decorated alcove? Is there a statue missing here?
I wouldn't say missing.
Destroyed?
Where there is light, there is shade. Where there is good, there must also be evil.
So where to go?
The Nameless One was probably the most powerful amongst us. Whenever anyone did anything evil, people believed that it was his fault.
Oh, and because everyone believed in him.
He became more and more powerful. It was simple for everyone. They could blame all their bad deeds on him.
Where is he now?
They banished him to the dungeon dimension. It's probably the greatest story of all time.
That will be told another time.
The dungeon dimension.
He was banished, and many small gods were put in his place. Murphy, the god of stupid coincidences. Monday, the god of bad moods. Alki, the god of drunkenness.
hundreds, thousands of little gods that people could blame when they did something bad or stupid.
I have to go. If I address him, he might tell me a joke. I don't want to risk it.
All right, let's talk to the goddess of the arts.
Hi.
Hello, my young friend.
So you're the goddess of the arts.
The arts? Is that like when you make a face out of macaroni and glue it to some paper?
Not exactly, Wilbur. What?
The world consists of stories.
We got stuck there.
Now you both know the world would be terribly dull without a good laugh.
Every time a painter picks up his brush, a sculptor his chisel, or a bard his lute, they are singing my praises.
But they've forgotten about you.
The sculptor sing too.
Leave it, gnome. She's not so good with words.
I have to go.
Go forth and create something.
Let's create freedom.
I don't really know what to ask her.
I want to repeat that stuck phrase. Let's talk to the god of riddles.
Good day.
Do you wish me a good day? Or mean that it is a good day whether I want it or not? Or that you feel good this day? Or that it is a day to be good on?
Shush. So you're the god of riddles then?
If you're the god of puzzles, I have a serious bone to pick with you.
Why?
Why does everything have to be so complicated?
Yeah.
An unlocked chest? Someone who just helps? For free? Is that too much to ask for?
Nothing worth having in this world simply falls into your lap.
That's the problem.
Yes, but chess puzzles to open doors?
Yeah.
Complicated machines in submerged temples? Machines that must have been completely pointless when the temples were still in operation?
I agree. This is all just a distraction from the story.
Yeah.
I don't know what the problem is. Doing a little dance to create a flash of lightning?
First game.
Brilliant.
I have to go.
Go out into the world with open eyes. It is full of riddles.
And the chess thing must have been a reference to the first Harry Potter movie, The Sorcerer's Stone.
Sure, there are lots of puzzles to solve. But he's more likely to throw new questions at me than help me answer old ones.
And finally, the god of good stories, or narrative.
Hello,
said the young hero, and then asked the decisive question.
Well, that's kind of a question and a statement. You are the god of stories? I love stories.
I've always liked stories, especially the story of the knight Ni as he rode out to slay the evil dragon.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, one of my finest.
You wrote the knight Ni story?
I wrote all stories. So to speak.
Through humans.
Boy falls in love with girl, hooker with a heart, happy ending, all my inventions. Everything since is just variations on a theme, really.
Wow!
I also invented the words and, wide, and jam, as well as the letters E, Q, and L. Oh, and the Oxford comma. The last has, however, not been accepted by the majority.
Have to go,
he said, and went out into the world. A short while later, he said...
Nothing.
I'm sure he could tell a great many stories. Long ones, too. But I'm worried about Remy.
Let's get this. We have to call it an episode, too, guys.
That's Remy's shrinking ring! That means he was here!
We can use that to get in the
Remy!
Pipe.
This is Remy's shrinking ring. It's pretty powerful. It can shrink a fully grown gnome to rat size.
Awesome.
This lake looks weird.
Mm-hmm.
The water is so dark and somehow wrong.
Oh, it's real water.
That I could just swim to the island.
Ooh, I wouldn't try that if I were you.
Yeah, I think that's safe.
And if I build a raft and get myself a small rowing boat?
No boat can cross this lake, spoke the mighty voice of the highest of the gods. We can only explain to you how to get over the lake.
Huh.
Maybe Maybe the lake is cursed. I can feel something evil, and a chilling cold emanating from the water. The gods must know how to cross a lake like this.
Yes, we do.
Maybe the lake. The god.
Yes.
An island in the lake with the ruins of the creepiest temple I've ever seen. An island.
What about this statue?
Is this also a goddess?
No, that is an Amazon. They guarded our temples.
Didn't do a particularly good job of it, did they?
Okay. We gotta talk to them again. We have to talk to them again, find out how to cross that lake. There's a can over there. What if we go in there? Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop the boogie.